I'm going to talk about garbage this morning. I know it has been a topical issue, and you've seen that in newspapers. Who would have thought 50 years ago or 40 years ago we were called the old garbos? Nowadays, we are called the sustainability, circular economy, waste management, environmental sciences, and the smartest dude in town. Yeah, so that's how the world has changed. But let me talk about waste first, and let me start with talking about thematics of waste, and then I'm going to talk about Cleanaway and how we fit into all of this picture. So you would have seen in the last 6 months more news about waste, war on waste, circular economy, climate change than you've seen in probably 10, 20 years before. Now, it is not for me to say what side of debate you sit on the climate change. That's your own personal decision. But at the end of the day, where the world is moving now, we can easily see a world of circular economy. We can easily see a world where what we consume and what goes into your waste baskets will come back into economy in some form or shape. And that's where the waste management comes in. So you cannot create a circular economy of future without some kind of a waste management company holding its pay. I think that's an important point. That's where Cleanaway comes up. So the other thing in Australia is you would have seen, for the first time, COAG put waste on the agenda. Never ever happened in the history of this country where waste was on the agenda of the COAG. And within first meeting, all of the ministers and the prime minister made a statement on waste. So what you are seeing in front of you is a fundamental shift in this sector. It's maturing very fast, and that's what I want to have a chat with you about this morning. Let me talk about fundamentally what a waste management company actually does. It is no different than a normal utility, whether it's gas, water, electricity. So for example, you would have millions of customers like we do, small to medium enterprise, large customers, large national customers, all of the municipalities in the country. So a company like Cleanaway would have millions of customers. Most of the customers are contracted. 85% of customers of Cleanaway or any waste management company like us would have a contract. Our contracts are anything from 3 years to 10 years. A municipality which we would be servicing in your area, we would have a 10 to 15 year contract. A small to medium enterprise would be anything from 1 to 3 years. A building like this could be 3 to 5 years. So 85% of the customers of a waste management company generally are contracted. So what you have an opportunity of a recurring revenue. So today, we can sit here and we can probably forecast to some level of accuracy our revenue for the next couple of years. Subsequently, if you can manage your cost right, you can forecast your earnings to some level. The other good part in waste management is what we call operating leverage. What that means is if you can increase your top line by 2, 3, 4%, your bottom line should go from 1 to 3, so 3 to 9, 8 to 9%. And how it works is, for argument's sake, if a truck is running up and down on George Street, and you pick up 40 customers, the 41, the 42, the 43, and 44 is actually free, in a sense that your fixed cost is done. Your truck is there, your driver is there. That's called operating leverage. And that's why you would see, and I'll show you some of the results of Cleanaway, operating leverage is a big deal in a waste management company. It is a GDP stock. It is fundamentally a GDP stock, but what comes out of that is an operating leverage and a fantastic cash flow. Because waste is generated by human beings, and that's GDP related, right? There are about 140 municipal councils in Australia, and Cleanaway has about 95 of those, which are about 10 to 15 year contracts, right? Just to start with the company. So Cleanaway is about 100 years old company. It was used to be part of the Brambles Group, started by a young lad in Newcastle about 100 years ago. And subsequently, it has gone through multiple permutations and combinations, now being an independent listed company. So just give you some scale, about 6,000 employees, 4,500 vehicles, almost 5,000 now, 140,000 CNI, commercial industrial customer, 95 plus municipal councils. We recycle about 14,500 tons of steel, 730 kgs of sharp smart, which I'll come to that in a minute, medical waste, 140 million liters of hydrocarbon oil. We are one of the largest refiner of oil in the country. Go figure. As a waste management company, we refine more oil than big refineries. So all the waste oil from auto workshops gets refined into fuel oil and base oil. every single doctor or medical surgery you will go to, the yellow bin and the purple bin you go. Hopefully you never have to go to an operating theater. But if you're conscious and you see that purple bin, chances are CleanAway is picking that up. So we are the largest in municipal, largest in commercial industrial, largest in medical, largest in hazard, largest in non-hazardous, and liquid waste. Fine? We are top 20 in the world. Now, you might wonder why this slide. What's the big deal? You're top 20 in the world. Waste management companies all around the world are consolidating. The largest company in the world is now a $20 billion US dollar company. This sector has fundamentally moved since you probably saw it last time. CleanAway is the largest in the country and largest in the Asia Pacific. But you can see the waste management world is dominated by the Americans and the Europeans. And why Europeans? Because generally Europeans are much ahead in waste management and circular economy than the rest of the world. And the US obviously has scale. So just to give you a sense of where CleanAway fits in. This is our last year's numbers. They're all green, which is good. But more importantly is our last 5 years' history. We've grown our net CAGR revenue grown by 13%, EBITDA by 19%, and that's the operating leverage come through, EBIT by 25.4%, NPAT by 27%, EPS by 25.3%. And what is more comforting is the cash at the back of it. Cash has grown by 18.8%, free cash by 81.8%. We have managed our cash capital very well. Return on invested capital is up, and DPS is up by 24%. Now, let me explain to you what a typical waste management company does. So this is what we call the value chain. The front end is the collections. What you see on the road is the front lift, the rear lift, the skip trucks running around with the big brand on the side of it. That's called the collections piece. That is just the star of the game. When you pick up that waste, that has to go somewhere. Those days of 20, 30 years ago, when you would lift and dump, as they used to call it, find a hole and put the waste in, it has actually gone. Every single ton you pick it up, you have to process it in a regulated manner. What then you do is we pick up that waste, and that's, I'm talking about millions of tons every week, goes into a resource recovery center where that waste gets converted into some kind of a recycled material, paper, plastic, cardboard, glass, all that stuff, and rest can get treated into landfills or refineries, et cetera. What you're hearing recently is the middle portion where the world is changing. What used to happen till a couple of years ago, that all the developed countries would pick up the waste, or as you call a yellow bin in Sydney, the commingled recycling waste, would get that picked up, would do some kind of resource recovery in developed countries, which included Australia, UK, or America, and then it would go to China. And that's where the kids would sit there in developing countries and go through the waste of the developed nation and then convert into some kind of a material which can go into recycled material. Now, I don't know about you, but there is something in my value, something wrong about kids of one nation looking at the waste of other nation. And that's what China did. China and the Southeast Asian countries said last year, we are happy to take the recycled material from the developed countries. What we are not prepared to take is the waste. What we are looking for to do is you, US or America or Canada or Europe, give me your recycled material. So what that means is do a resource recovery properly and then give me a resource recovered material so that I can put into my manufacturing business. See, what has also happened in the developed countries, manufacturing has gone to zero practically. We have shipped down our manufacturing jobs to the low-cost country sourcing. So guess what? That's where the material is going to get used. We are now looking at a global commodity of recycled products. It's like iron ore, plastic palletization, whatever you call it, the recycled waste is now a global commodity. Better we resource recover, better we can ship it all over the world. The rest can go into treatment and landfill. So that's a typical value chain. The front part of the business in Australia is always going to be low barrier to entry. Theoretically, any one of you can run a truck and start collecting waste. What you can't do, though, you can't resource recover or put in a landfill or refinery. That back end of that business, you need an EPA permit, and we call them prized infrastructure assets. The company CleanAway today market cap is $4.5 billion. You cannot create a new CleanAway even with $20 billion. The 120 prized infrastructure we have doing resource recovery, treatment, and disposal you cannot create them from ground up because some of the licenses which CleanAway has, you will not get it now because they were given in a period of time. The refineries you can't create from scratch because you need an EPA permit. See, in waste, there's a concept called NIMBY, not in my backyard, right? Each one of us create a waste, but nobody wants a waste facility in their backyard. In fact, you would not want to see a CleanAway transfer station in your neighborhood. You'll be the first one with the placard, right? So the fact that we have 120 of those assets surrounded all over the country gives us a significant competitive advantage. And that is what will secure the future of CleanAway. Right? So that's kind of a typical how value chain works. We have a concept of evolving ton. Every ton you pick up, you make money while you collect. Then you make money when you recycle or resource recover. And you make money when you take to treatment and disposal. These businesses are normally making 20, 23, 24, 25% EBITDA, right? Generating about 90-plus operating cash flow conversion. For the last couple of years, what we have been doing actively in our company is basically replacing our what we call unlicensed sites, or as I call it, depreciating assets into appreciating assets. We have worked pretty hard over the last 4.5 years to build a very significant portfolio of prized infrastructure assets. And I'm absolutely confident and proud to say that CleanAway would now today have one of the best prized infrastructure assets for waste management in this country by far. And I would absolutely also confident to say that it will be the second and third party will be significantly behind us. We have 250 locations all over the country, 6,000 employees, and 120 prized infrastructure assets spread across right from Karratha, Darwin, Cairns, Townsville, Rockhampton, Brisbane, Melbourne, Sydney, you name it. Okay? Because we are servicing municipal clients and commercial clients all over the country. So our mission statement is making a sustainable future possible. And I know these are 5-6 words, and every company has a mission. And I call ourselves a pragmatic greenies. We are a commercial greenies, if I can call it that way. It is about actually the waste agenda can only move forward if it is done pragmatically. And when we say making a sustainable future possible, we are saying there is a way, an absolute method today to treat waste properly in such a way that it can go into a circular economy, which can then does not create issues for future generations. I think that's what we believe in. And we are trying to do it very profitably and successfully.